चैप्टर वन रियल नंबर्स पार्ट थ्री। सो रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन एलसीएम एंड एचसीएफ ऑफ टू गिवन नंबर्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन एलसीएम एंड एचसीएफ ऑफ टू गिवन नंबर्स। सो एलसीएम इनटू एचसीएफ इक्वल टू प्रोडक्ट ऑफ two numbers, LCM into HCF equal to product of two given numbers. Okay, this is only the relationship between LCM and HCF. Okay, so we can write simply like this: LCM into HCF equal to A into B. Two numbers you take, A and B, whose product? Get LCM into HCF. So if you want to find out HCF means just to divide LCM. If you want to find out LCM means just to divide HCF. Okay, A equal to one number. One number equal to LCM into HCF by another number. A is one number, B is another number. So sometime they may ask, find out LCM HCF will be given. One number given, find out other number means that other number equal to LCM into HCF by one number, given number. Okay, so this is very important formula, so remember. So LCM into HCF equal to product of two numbers. Using this we will see now problem. Already you know, in lower class you study LCM HCF. What is LCM? Least common multiple. What is HCF? Highest common factor. Okay, in lower class you study. Now we have to find out LCM. Two numbers given means easily you can find out LCM and HCF. Clear? So how will you find out HCF? In by factorization method easily you can do. Okay, 35 here, 5 table you can easily divide 7. 35 can be written as 5 into 7. Okay, same way 125, this also will go 5 table, 2 times 5 times. Again, 5 table. So this 125 can be written as 5 into 5 into 5. That is equal to 5 cube. That is equal to 5 cube. Clear? Now we have to find out HCF. Therefore, HCF is. HCF, how will you find out, means this factor and this number factors and this number factor. You see, it should be common. 5 factor is common here. 5 factor is common. Okay, so whose power, you have to see the power. Here power 1 is there, here power 3 is there. So lowest one you have to take, lowest power. Okay, among these two factors, lowest power you have to take. That means 5. So HCF is 5. Okay. Again, I will explain. You see, 35 can be written 5 into 7. 125 is 5 cube. So in this two number, common factor is 5. Okay. Here 5 is there. Here 5 power 3 is there. But lowest power you take, 5 you have to take. That is HCF. Okay. Then LCM. Both the number, all the factor you have to write. Okay, you have to write highest power. Okay, see here 5 factor there, here also 5 factor there. But you have to take what? Highest power. 5 cube into 7. 7 also there. Here 7 there, but here 7 not there. But 7 you can write it as into 7 power 0. Clear? Into 7 power 0. So the highest factor is 7 power 1. So 7 you have to take. Right, so all the factor you have to write, both the number you have to see, all the factor. 5 first written, highest power here, then one more factor there, 7 there, that also you have to write, highest power you have to write. Okay, this is LCM. So that is equal to 125 into 7. How much it will be? 35 carry 3 17 carry 1 7 8 875 is the HCF. Clear? Next, we can verify. By using this, we can verify. Clear? Now, we will do verification. The problem itself given. The LCM into HCF equal to product of two numbers. So, first you take left-hand side. So, left-hand side is what is there? That you write. LCM into HCF. Now, what is LCM? 875. What is HCF? 5. Now multiply 5 into 5, 25, carry 2, 35, 37, carry 3, 40, 43, right, 4, 3, 75. Next to product of two numbers, right hand side you take, right hand side is A into B, product of two number is A into B, okay, A is 35, B is 125, you multiply. Same you will get 25, carry 2, 10, 12, carry 1, 6, 625, 125 into 5 is 625, you know already. So 15, carry 1, 7, okay, and 3. Got it. Same. Therefore, LHS equal to RHS. LHS equal to RHS. Okay. Hence verified. Hence verified. Therefore, we can write it LCM and HCF equal to product of two numbers. Understand? See, in exercise 1.2, third problem we will see. Okay. Find the LCM and the HCF of the following integers. By applying the prime factorization method, already you know prime factorization method. Last problem also you have done. Clear? Only how to take prime number and divide. That's all. Okay. Now you take first 12, you take 12, the prime number 2, you divide means how much? 6. Next again 2 means 3. That's all. Okay. Up to that last number should be also prime. Up to that you have to divide. Further you cannot divide. Okay. If you divide means 3, divided by 3 again 1 you will get. Okay. Better you stop up to here. So this 12 can be written as product of these factors you write. So this is nothing but 2 into 2 is 2 squared into 3. Better you okay make it in the powers here. 2 into 2, 2 squared you write it. Then only what easily you can find out LCM and HCF. Now 15 you take. Divided by 3. 3 is prime. Divided by 3 means 5. That's all. So 15 can be written as 3 into 5. Next you take 21. 21 also 3 table it will go. So 7. So 21 can be written as 3 into 7. Okay. Now 12, you got it 12, therefore 12 you write, better you write separately, okay. So that for the time being you write separately. Okay, straight away also you can do, time being you write separately so that you will understand better. 5 into 3 into 5, here 21 is 3 into 7. Okay. Therefore, HCF we can find out. Therefore, HCF is, okay, HCF of these three numbers is, see, all the number common factor, all the number common factor you have to take, right? So, what is the common factor? In this number, 3 is there, here also 3 there, here also 3 there. So, 3 is the common factor of all the these three numbers. Therefore, you take this 3 is HCF. So only how to take the common factor, that's all. Okay. Next, LCM. LCM means all the factor you have to write. Okay. These three number, all the factor you write. First 2 write, 2 squared. 2 squared is only this number there, but still you have to write. Because here also what? 2 power 0 we can write. Clear? LCM you have to take highest power. That's why what? You have to write 2 power 2. into. Then 3 is the factor. Okay, 3, all the numbers, you see the 3 factor, 1, 1, 1 is there, power 1 is there. So 3 power 1 is 3. Next you have the factor 5, so 5 you write. Next to what factor? 7, 7 you write. Clear? So this is LCM, so all the factor you have to write. Okay, whose power is highest one you have to write. So clear? Now you have to simplify and write. That is equal to how much? 4 into 3 into 5, 15 into 7. So here 60 into 7. So 6 into 7, 42. So 420 is LCM. That's all. So here question is find the LCM and the HCF. Okay, by using prime fact. This is called prime factorization method. Okay. So here HCF and the LCM we got. Okay. So next problem, second substitution. 17, 23, 29. 17, 23, 29, all prime numbers. So you cannot do what? Already prime numbers. Again, clear? You cannot. Now we will see second problem, right? 17, 23, 29. So all prime numbers. Clear? Prime number means having exactly 2 factors. Already 1 factor there. Another factor what? 1. Clear? 1 and itself. That's why this 17 can be written as 17 into 1. For understanding purpose. Okay. Straight away also you can write. HCF is 1 you can write. That is understood. Clear? Now for the time being, for understanding purpose, I am writing. 17 equal to 17 into 1. 23 equal to 23 into 1. 29 equal to 29 into 1. Therefore, HCF is the common factor here, 1. So, 1 you write. Clear? Now, LCM. LCM is all the factor you have to write. 17, 23, 29, 29 into 1. That is, we can ignore. Same thing only. So, this you multiply means 1, 1, 3, 3, 9. You will get. You multiply and see 1, 1, 3, 3, 9. You will get correctly. Okay? So next we will see fourth problem, very important. So repeated questions in CBSE, repeated questions, very important. See, if HCF of 306, 357 equal to 9, that means two numbers given, one is A, another one B, then HCF is 9 given, then you have to find out LCM of these two numbers. Okay, so let you take one number is A, you take 306, and another number is B, you take 657, right? One number A, another number B you take, okay? And HCF is given, HCF is 9, it is given. Therefore, we know that LCM equal to, we have to find out LCM. So we know that LCM equal to product of two numbers A into B by HCF. You see the formula, clear? That is LCM into HCF equal to product of two numbers. That product of numbers is a numerator, you write. Then divide the HCF means you will get LCM, correct? Now just to replace it, what is A? 306 into what is B? 357 by HCF is 9. Clear? So 9 table, easily we can cancel this. Right? 9 table, how many time will go? 3 time. What is the remainder? 3. 36 means 4. 34. So 34 into 6, 57. You multiply 2, 2, 3, 3, 8. That's the answer. Okay. Therefore, LCM of 306, 657 is 22338. Right. So next problem, we'll see fifth problem. check whether 6 power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. Solution is A. So, this 6 power n you take, whose prime factor? 6 prime factor is 2 into 3, whole power n. So, prime factor of 6 power n equal to 2 into 3, whole power n. Clear? Now, it is clear that 5 is not a factor of 6 power n. 5 is not there. In this 5 is not there. Because 2 is there means 5 should be there. Clear? Then only what it will be? 10. So, it will end with 0. Clear? End with 0. But here 5 is not there. So, that what? We cannot get ending digit what? 0. Clear? Hence, there exists no any natural number n for which 6 power n ends with digit 0. Clear? When it is 5 is not there, clear? Then you will not get end with 0. Clear? No any natural number n for which 6 power n ends with digit 0. Clear? Okay, power n is maybe power 2, 3, 4 like that. Clear? But the factor 5 is not there inside. 2 into 5 only 10. So when you will get 2 into 5, 10. So 10 power anything, last digit you will get 0. Clear? 10 cube is what? 1000. So ending digit 0 will come. Clear? Understand? So that is only important. N, there is no any natural number n for which 6 power n ends with the digit 0. Clear? That's all. So next problem, sixth problem is, explain why these two number, this number are composite number. You know very well, composite number means more than two factors. Okay. So you have to check this number, whether you are getting more than two factor or not. If you get more than two factor, then it is composite number. So first problem, you will see A, right? 7 into 11 into 13. Plus 13. So this fully what one term. Okay. This is another term. So better you take 13 is common. 13 is common. You take means 7 into 11 plus 1. So 13 into 7 into 11 is 77 plus 1. How much? 78. Okay. 78. So clearly what it is more than two factors. Clear? Because into one also coming. 78 also even number. Okay. It is itself composite number. Therefore, you multiply n number means what you will get? Composite number. Therefore, more than two factor. Therefore, it is composite number. Bracket you write more than two factors. More than two factors. Okay. B also you see. Same way you have to do. You see here what is common here, these two term here up to here one term, into there means that is one term, then another term, the two term 5 is common, take 5 is common. So 7 into remaining number you write, 7 into 6 into 4 into except 5, okay, 1 no need to write, plus taken common, so 1 it will be, when you take common, okay, 1, if you multiply and see correctly will come, this multiply 5 will come, here 5 into 1, 5, right. So 5 into this fully multiply, how much it will be? 42, this one how much? 12 into 24, 42 into 24, multiply and see, 8, 16, 4, 8, so 8, 10, carry 1, 10, yes. 1008 plus 1, that is 5 into 1090. So already one prime number there. Okay, one more number is there. Clear? So into one means having, simply write into one means having more than two factors. So it is composite number. Therefore, it is also composite number. Bracket you write more than two factors. Okay. So next what I will attach homework problems at the end of the video. Today you do the homework. Okay.